Welcome to the Rouses Point Rec Center and a scrimmage between Missisquoi Vally Thunderbirds and your hometown Northeastern Clinton Cougars. Face off one back. Gallucci sending it around the boards. Lombard starting the game up on wing here. Passes out of the zone up the middle. Thunderbirds in their own zone. Chip it up into the neutral zone. Coulomb sending it in deep. Going for a change. Back around. Pops up the middle. Thunderbirds now. Gain the blue. Nice move by Thunderbirds. Shot on goal. Number 19.
Point out, Eric, we don't have the Missisquoi roster, so we can't be sharing any Missisquoi names.
Yes, it's being a scrimmage, we don't have the numbers, the name roster for the Thunderbirds, and there will not be a score capped.
You and I have to remember. How's your memory?
Oh, sharp. Ask what's her name? His name. Excuse me. What is that?
And it's 25 minute half instead of the usual 3 periods.
Yes. Thunderbirds bunched up. Come up neutral zone. Chip forward. Cross the blue. Cougars right there to bunch them up. Sent around now. Bedard chips it off the board around his opponent. Down, nice pass by Bedard to Fallon with a goal. Nice play by Bedard, chipping it off the boards, making room for himself, going all the way down and finding Fallon ready to receive the puck with a nice goal.
Even though the scoreboard says zero, we know now.
We're up by one, but
our memory is good here, 1-0.
Every game, every goal should be a 0-0 start. Yeah. You know, there is no lead ever. Miller taking a deep. Miller lighting the lamp. Quick hands of I believe that's Raymond Miller.
That didn't take long.
No freshman, one of our many freshmen. We have a strong freshman lineup, equal to the senior lineup. A lot of well-developed players that have been on born on skates and play an aggressive style. Buck now at the blue. Sent in Miller. Miller holding on to the puck, doing a great job. Chipped up. Missisquoi to the neutral zone. Gallucci there. Sending it wide. Vazor giving chase. Gordon. Quick shot in by Guerin. Ethan Guerin. Another freshman that's playing defense. As well as goalie. Anthony Barcombe behind his net. Sent in deep to the Cougar zone. Guerin giving chase. Around the boards to the neutral zone. Thunderbirds being forechecked by Nick Rao. Into Nick Rao, sent in deep. Lombard behind the net with some speed. Stick on the puck to Dupuy. Sent in deep. Around the boards to the point. Shot covered up. Oh, cleared out by Thunderbirds, and we're going to have an icing call. Number 7, Jack Bolson on the ice. Another freshman. Bedard LaFountain, and Miller. The Millers, identical twins. You get Zachary and Raymond. I believe Raymond is number 13. I gotta have to check that. They're very difficult to tell apart. And they both have a great attitude of dig and work hard and not be defeated. If there's a scrap, they'll be at it. Vazor, Richard, and Miller now facing off. And I believe we have Gagno on defense, another freshman, along with Riley Duffy, a senior. Vazor sends it in deep. Gagno pinching in. Gagno, I seen take a slap shot during warm-ups that I was very impressed with. Puck comes down in the feet of Duffy, bumps up Vassar, breaking his own. Miller at the blue. Miller between the opponent's legs. We're going to have a penalty on the Missisquoi. Not sure what the call was. Cougars now on a power play. Guerin shooting the puck from the point. Rowell circling on the perimeter, loses an edge, pulls it back, great recovery. Out to the blue line and out. Cougars tag up, Guerin sends it in on net. Shot down the ice. Now there is no, the icing call for high school hockey is traditional icing. We're on a power play. When you're killing a penalty, you can ice the puck and it's not whistled down. It was a rule change to youth hockey this year, where if you ice the puck, it goes back into your own zone and you have to face the music. Bombard with a nice low shot and goalie gloves it down. 57 seconds remaining in the man advantage for the Cougars. Few shots on goal. Here we are with Miller, Richard, Gallucci, Bedard. Puck into the corner. Gallucci sent in deep to Bedard. Around to Kaluom, clearing attempt. Miller in the slot, chips it high. Gallucci down low to recover. Bedard taking the point position, sent down low. Chipped up in front. To Miller, to Richard. Shot on goal. Centering. Gallucci there to break up the pass. Bedard in the corner. Richard now passing the puck out in the middle. Gallucci picked off. Held into the zone deep. The Cougars go for a line change. Miller giving forecheck. Sent down low. Ooh. Shot high by Missisquoi. Down deep in Missisquoi end, 24, coming around to 15. Centering pass, number 7, looking down at the puck, Loopy picks that off. Miller now, chipping the boards, Ethan Guerin. Puck clears, no icing, it's going to be waved off. Missisquoi behind their goal. To the winger, number 7, Miller right there, giving forecheck. Very important part of hockey is a forecheck. You gotta play like a rabid dog, chasing that puck, being all over it. No time for a break when you're forechecking. We've got a power play now for the Thunderbirds. 1 back by Gordon, sent down the ice by Coulomb. Thunderbirds back to retrieve, set up their power play. Gordon giving chase. No pressure to the neutral zone, out comes the puck. Very important that you always have one guy forechecking. You don't want to give up a zone. Centering attempt, picked out by Rao, clears the zone. Rao forechecking hard, gets his man, gets the puck, centers out Gordon, and they score. There's the forecheck put on by the Cougars, Nick Rao. Will not let it go. He gets that puck back out, centering the pass to a nice goal by Gordon. Hard work, determination by Rao. Often the case, a shorthanded goal, the power play team that has a man advantage thinks they have an advantage when actually the opponent is going to place out the 4 best players to kill the penalty, and there's a goal by Missisquoi from the corner. When you have that power play or the man advantage, you think you have the upper hand, but there's actually more ice for the opposing team to work with as well. When you forecheck, you have more ice because you think you're at an advantage. Therefore, you're more lackadaisical, and the opponent can really make up some ground on you.
Well, if we were keeping score, it'd be 3-1 right now, but we're not keeping score.
All right, 0-0 is your score. Turning your back to the play, that's a big no-no in hockey. You've got to know where that puck is 100% of the time you're on the ice. You never want to turn your back to the puck. You always want to pivot, have your eye in the play, eye in the puck. The 1-2 seconds it takes to regroup and find out where that puck is, you're going in the wrong direction. And a hockey shift is generally 40 seconds, so if you should be able to pay attention for 40 seconds to where that puck is. Icing is going to be a call. Face-off will be in the Thunderbird zone. Miller down low in the corner. Digging. Thunderbirds come up. It's into the blue line. They gain the neutral. Send it in deep. Puck out. Miller. Gains the red. To the blue. Gets a shot off. Thunderbird's captain takes it to the red. Richard now gains blue. Offside's a call. Cougars going for a line change. Gordon drawing the puck back into his zone. Gagneau giving chase. Two Thunderbirds on him. Gagneau, a freshman, up to the Bombard. Sent in deep. Rowell giving chase. The Bombard behind the net. Pops it out to the point. Down low to Rowell. Back to the point. Gagneau sends it around the back. Cougars on the perimeter here. Sent in by Duffy. Rowell to the corner. No pressure to the net. Here come the Thunderbirds. Sent in. Rowell behind his net to Duffy. Two men on Duffy. Gordon down low. To Rowell. Up to the Bombard. Tucking in. Bombard throwing the body out there. Tripping call here, I believe, on the Cougars.
Nice as well.
Puck up, Thunderbird. Shot on goal, digging. Anthony there to cover it up. Anthony Barkholm, senior. Cougars going for a late line change.
They've got a man in the box, too.
The Fountain on a breakaway. Lucci losing the stick. Thunderbirds, nice backhander. Again, a second attempt. Miller behind the net. Glucci chips it over. Miller. Thunderbird's doing a good job on the power play, putting two guys on the puck. Puck crosses the blue. In the feet, Glucci there to break it up. Sent down low. Coulomb sends it back to the corner. Puck out. Miller. Miller on a breakaway. Number seven giving chase. Miller, backhand shot. Goalie able to hang on. Oh, puck seemed to be in the net there. I believe goalie may have gloved it back or slid back into his net. Lee Miller receiving a goal, a shorthanded goal. Again, where you get caught up ice, putting pressure down low and a puck pops up, it's not always an opportunity when you're on a power play. Needs to be recognized. Again, you see the Thunderbirds having a shorthanded goal scored on them. You got to cover that back door. Chipped in. Guerin now. Shooting Miller. Vazor behind the net, centering. Thunderbirds at the red. Dump it in low and hard on the ice. Guerin to Miller. To Gordon. Gordon gains a blue. Quick snapshot. Vazor giving chase. Behind the net. Gordon, nice pass, centering. Ooh, we got a little we got a penalty call here. on Gordon. I believe it was tripping. I thought we were going to call it a defensive tackle. But it was tripping. Sent down the ice by Nick Rao. Thunderbirds on a power play. Neutral zone. Gain the blue, quick shot. Markholm pushing it to the corner. Sent out of the zone by Coulomb. Number 9 back to retrieve it for the Thunderbirds. Up to the neutral zone. Rao right there to put pressure on him, turn it back over and send it down the ice. Lombard giving chase. Rao turning the puck over. It's in his feet. Puck now, Cougar zone. Quick shot, wide of the net. Bedard now to the middle of Lombard. Lombard firing it from the red. Up the blue. Thunderbirds, everybody's feet are standing still. Not what you want to be doing in hockey. You always want to be moving. Puck slapped in, Duffy. Icing your call. Face off in the Cougar zone. LaFountain, Bedard, Miller. LaFountain draws it back. Doopy there to send it around. Miller. LaFountain in the corner. Dangles his player. Around the middle. Guerin shooting the puck without looking up. You want to be looking where you're shooting. Everything changes. You don't want to be looking down at that puck when you shoot. You want to try to have your eyes on the prize of the net or the person you're passing it to. Chipped up, Miller. Gonna get a penalty call. Interference, I believe. Roughing is the call. We have a goalie change here now. Ledoux coming in.
Exactly what the Cougars want, a power play.
Oh, man.
Half of their goals on shorthanded goals.
Yeah. Sent back, Gallucci. Up to the blue. Puck there. Ledoux with his first save. Gallucci in the corner. Strong on the puck, sends it down. One man giving chase, it would be Miller. Not committing to the back of the net, very wise. Young Miller, you don't want to chase behind the net, especially in a man-down situation. Coulomb firing the puck up. Thunderbird right there. Into Ledoux. Nice shot by number 23, but directly into Ledoux. Guerin, Gordon, Doopy. Sent down the ice by Lombard, giving chase. Lombard beating his man to the puck, chipped it to the back. Doopy now firing it back in. off the blocker. Well, Bombard right there on it. Thunderbird's up to the neutral zone. Garen will blast it back in the zone. Garen, freshman with a good shot. LeBombard tying the puck up, killing some clock on this penalty kill. Around Gordon now with the puck, back to his point man Garen. Little snapshot in on goal, and gloved and saved in by the goalie for a stoppage of play. In the Thunderbird zone. Passed up. Thunderbirds to the neutral zone. Rowe there to break it up and send it in. Referee mixed up in the play. Thunderbird's having a hard time here. Rao. Back to Miller. Or Gagneau, rather. Rao to Gagneau. Gains a red. Slap shot. Rifle of a slap shot. Have a high sticking call. Missisquoi in the corner sends down low. Gallucci there to send it out. Thunderbirds with the man advantage. Miller and LaFountain on the forward line, penalty kill. Miller, centering attempt. Out of the zone, LaFountain to Gallucci, sending it in deep. Sending it down deep to Fountain. On a line change. Miller there to pick it up. Registering a shot. Sent up neutral zone. Thunderbirds. Man trailing. Sent back in deep. Garen there to pick it up. Thunderbirds now. Centering attempt. Sent down the ice. Richard giving chase, number 7. Bedard now. Shot from the point. Doopy, Noah Doopy. Thunderbirds, neutral zone. Coulomb, Doopy, putting a shoulder on his man. Coulomb, or Garen, excuse me, gains the red and sends it. Bedard. And a stoppage of play. It's kind of been going through the paces the last few shifts. We're in viewing. A bunch of odd bounces. LeBombard. Puck sent around back, Rao, centering attempt, backhand shot by LeBombard and held onto by the goalie. Gagneau chips it in deep, LeBombard. Duffy holding it in, sent down low, LeBombard, quick snapshot. Rao, Gordon, Gordon back. Sent up, Lombard gets a body plate on him. Rao holding on to it, getting a shot. Duffy back to play the puck. Gagno. Gordon sends it in deep and goes for a change. LaFountain now. Behind the net. Thunderbirds coming out of the zone. Gain the red. Shot on Ledoux. Nate gloves it. Colucci. Nice pass up to Miller. His man likes to play the body. Miller gets by him. Centering attempt. Thunderbirds at the blue. Neutral zone. Delayed offsides. Cougars regroup and go back in. Good pressure by the Cougars on their forechecks. End to end here. Old backhander by seven and held on. Doopy. Off the boards and out. Offside your call. Out to Bedard. Gets tipped up. Richard giving chase. A little bit of a dangerous play by Highgate. Just blindly chipping the puck over. Cost him a turnover. Doopy. Vazor. Bedard taking it in the soft issue there. A little limp. Gordon giving chase, now Lombard behind the net. Rao to the point. Rao, turn, getting a shot on net. Centering pass, or attempt, I should say. And your first 25 minutes of the scrimmage. Good play by both teams.
Like Ledoux is still in net and looks like they're still coming in the same direction. They didn't switch ends at the half. Calvin Kastein taking over on the mic as Eric Richard had to head out to a youth game. That's what happens when you get kids playing at different levels. You got to be in two places at the same time, and believe me, I know all about trying to be in two, sometimes three places at the same time. That's one reason why we're covering this scrimmage here. It's not a game, it's a preseason scrimmage. So they're playing 25 minute halves instead of the usual three periods. And not keeping the score on the scoreboard, but I guarantee you everybody on either team knows that the score would be 4-1 if they were keeping the score. It's the second day of December 2017. And this is Missisquoi out of Swanton, the Thunderbirds here playing the Northeastern Clinton Central School Cougars here at the Rouses Point Civic Center. Neither team provided us with a roster, so Eric knew all the Cougars, so there was no problem there, but I might recognize some of these folks if they had their helmets off, but we won't be doing any name calling here as they get up close and personal. So again, one of the reasons we are covering this is because no other immediate conflicts as far as our time, so we're able to be here today. And a lot of home matches for the Cougars where we're not going to be available. In December, we've got a lot of Christmas concerts to worry about. We've got a dance recital in Malone we're going to be covering because that's one of the few things where we actually make money for doing it. Here, chances are not one new viewer patron will step up out of the hockey families to support hometown cable. When they're relying on the viewer support. We get a chance to make a few dollars on a dance recital, we're going to be there. And also coming up within the next week or two is the Clinton Community College graduation, another paying event. So we're able to make a few dollars, so that's where we're going to be. Viewer supported, but very few families who understand that. Some just think it's just supposed to happen. My kids are playing sports and somebody's supposed to be there putting it on cable or the internet. Check out our website and then try to find another one like that anywhere in the country. Sometime tomorrow we'll hit 4,800 videos online on our website. We had 9,700. And the website had to come down because there was just too many videos for the place that was hosting them. Right now I would estimate that if we had our entire library online, we'd have 25,000 local events available for viewing on hometown cable. An astronomical number when you think about it. 25 pieces of local history. 25,000 pieces of local history. I'm going to find an old diary or something from 200 years ago we considered a great find. Letters, Civil War letters. Here we've got the actual history, actual folks participating, and we've got in many cases four generations of a family, that's been on hometown cable over the years. So if you're watching this, we need your support. You are a viewer, and this is viewer supported television. Never done it. Maybe now is the time. If you've done it in the past and it hasn't been a while, maybe time to step up again. Now just under 20 to go in the second half. In this high school hockey scrimmage. Cougars keeping the pressure on. Is that going to be a trip? Probably so. Slashing, tripping. During one of the breaks, I looked toward the stand and I saw this girl going up there with a t-shirt on, with short sleeves and all. And here I am bundled up and not cold, but coolly comfortable with three layers on.
on my arms and five layers on the rest of my upper torso. But some people like the cold, and there's folks like me who don't like it. And hockey rinks aren't a good place for people who don't like the cold. Face off to the left of the Missisquoi goalie. Under a minute to go in for the power play. Cougars scored twice in an earlier shorthand with the shorthanded events. This time they're on a power play, so Missisquoi is shorthanded. I think Missisquoi scored one power play goal. Their only goal of the game. Excuse me, of the scrimmage. It's not a game. It may look like a game, but this is not a game. Now it's like the Cougars have gotten their fifth one with 22 seconds left in the power play. So if we were keeping track, it'd be 5-1 right now. But the scoreboard says 0-0. Like the Cougars snuck another one through, they get 6-1 if we were keeping score. If we had a roster, we could tell you who the new goalie is for the Cougars, number one. And the third goalie they've had so far, I think Eric told me off camera there were up to four fellows looking for playing time at the goalie position for the Cougars. Well, at least three of them will get some playing time today. Face off to the left of the goalie. Time on the clock, but I only see four skaters on the ice, and a quick goal for the Cougars. So I see four skaters for Missisquoi. if we're keeping score, it'd be 7-1 Cougars, but it's 0-0 in this scrimmage. Penalty coming up. This one will give Missisquoi a 90-second advantage. .1342 left in the second half of this scrimmage. Third shorthanded goal for the Cougars. They may start drawing penalties during the regular season just so they can score. They'll make it about 8-1. .1246 on the game clock. Jumping there by the referee. Icing, I believe. remaining in the second half. Games here, we're going to have the crew here wash the glass there to take the scuffs out. Approaching the 9 minute mark, the time remaining. Approaching the 8 minute mark. Approaching the 7 minute mark. To change the batteries. And we still haven't had a stoppage here. We changed batteries. We're down to 5.5. We've gone from about 10 minute mark to 5.5 before a whistle was sounded. That's my kind of hockey. Thank you. We're in the final 5 minutes of this cross-border sectional here. Missisquoi from the great state of Vermont here battling the Cougars on the point where Quebec, Vermont, and New York State intersect on the Rouses Point. The only one penalty up there for the blue team. Another power play for the Cougars. Under four left in the scrimmage. That power play ends with 58 seconds to go. Unofficially, if the crew can score, I believe it would be 9-1 Northeastern. That was not a mosquito that just zipped by us. December 2nd, 2017, scrimmage at Northeastern Clinton's home ice, at Rouses Point, the rec center. Missisquoi Union, in blue. That's one of the schools, along with Northeastern Clinton, at the folks in Alberg can attend. Folks in Alberg can, I believe, have their tuition paid if they come to Northeastern and or Shazy along with Missisquoi and BFA. Alberg and Isle of Mont. Okay. keeping score, I believe it would be 10-1. Under a minute to go. It'd be nice to go the next 32 seconds without a whistle. I'll give you a final reminder that you're watching viewer-supported local television hometown cable. The only place you're going to find this kind of programming is hometown cable. If you appreciate hometown cable being here, we'd appreciate hearing from you. So the final will be 10-1 unofficially. On the scoreboard, it's 0-0. That's the way it is in the scrimmage. So thanks for watching and supporting viewer-supported local television hometown cable. Win, lose, or draw, TV worthy of your support. And again, thank you for watching.